Welcome back, everybody, to DuckTales Remastered.
We did it, boys! All five treasures are mine! boys?
Sorry, McDuck, but your meddlesome nephews are a wee bit tied up at the moment.
Flintheart Glomgold, you put the Beagle boys up to this.
Guilty as charged, Scroogey. I've been the world's second richest duck long enough, but these treasures will soon change that.
Oh, tell your goons to release my boys.
Not till you fork over that last treasure.
Don't do it, Uncle Scrooge. Don't do it.
The way I see it, McDuck, you're not in much of a position to argue.
Yeah, aye. You drive a hard bargain, Glomgold. Take it, you filthy cheat.
Flintheart Glomgold, the richest duck in the world. How does it feel to be number two, Scroogey?
Magicka dispel!
Oh, it's so rude of me to drop in unannounced.
What are you doing here, Magicka? Quick, somebody sound the alarm! Duckworth, Mrs. Beagley, call the Pentagon! Sell me stock and bonds!
Not so fast, fools.
Wackaroody, Uncle Scrooge! I can't move! Me neither. Now I know how a statue feels.
Greedy old fools. These treasures are far more valuable than money.
And just what do you mean by that?
You find secret hidden inside old painting, yes? Painting of Drake von Bloodstone, also known as Count Dracula Duck. These treasures are part of spell to summon him.
Bah, what rubbish.
You will see. With power of Dracula Duck under my command, I will rule the world. Unless, you'd rather surrender number one dime, Scrooge. Dime is much gentler way to conquer world. Will save me great deal of trouble. Also, less risk of accidental Dracula bite.
The first dime I ever made? Never.
Then I will take precious nephews instead. You will bring me dime quickly enough after that.
Hey, dimpses are hostages. Find your own.
Quiet, piggle boys. Now I take leave. Bring number one dime to my home on Mount Vesuvius in 24 hours, or little nephews will become Snackula for Dracula. Yeah! Yeah. Oh, dear. Sometimes I still get carried away.
That lousy, no-good so-and-so. I stole those treasures, fair and square.
This is no time for bellyaching, Glomgold. I've got to save those boys.
Pah, forget it. That she-devil's long gone. You can't catch her now.
Maybe you're right, Flinty. That leaves me no choice. How about a deal? You help me get the boys back, and you can keep the five treasures.
Without your dime, I'll become the richest duck in the world, and you'll be nothing but a shriveled-up old has-been.
That dime's not worth 10 cents next to the safety of my boys. Do we have an agreement?
Are you joshing? It's a deal. You know what I think, McDuck? I think you've gone soft. You've let those pesky rugrats become a business liability, and I'm gonna be the richer for it.
Oh, go soak your head.
Okay, so the cutscene that played back there, that's the cutscene that plays when you get the fifth treasure, no matter what the fifth treasure actually is. It would just skip the other cutscene that you would get if you didn't get that treasure last. So that's how that works.
Now remember our deal, Flinty. Help me rescue the lads, and the treasure is yours.
You keep up your end, and I'll keep up mine.
So these two hated rivals, Scrooge McDuck and Flint Glomgold, are teaming up for stuff because of Magicka. Well, anyway, here we have the final level of the game, Mount Vesuvius. And this level, while not overall difficult, this first screen, this first little section right here, it's probably the hardest screen in the game. Simply because of A, how long it is, and B, what you're expected to do here. Like, you're supposed to use your short pogo jumps to get across there and not get hit by those freaking bats, but it's really difficult to do.
I didn't get to be number one by Buck and Doom.
But, yeah, basically, you get past this first screen and everything else is pretty much, it's easier, so to speak. At least I think it's easier. I find it easier. It's just, I could never do short pogo jumps correctly. Like, in this version or in the NES version. I don't know, maybe I just suck. Entirely possible. I'm not gonna be naive and say that's impossible. Once I get past the first screen, I'm like, okay, I'm home free. It's pretty simple platforming stuff from here on out.
It could be dangerous, McDuck. You go first.
I can't get enough, really, of old school platformers and such. Okay, I think here's where I mean by, you know, there's an achievement for consecutively pogo jumping 5 enemies without touching the ground. You have to do that within the course of the game, so that's that achievement or that trophy is not missable.
Hurry up, I'm growing old, just not as old as you.
I could just get up there. I know I can get. It's like, geez, I know I can get up there with a normal jump. Right. There is more treasure down there in places where I'm not going, but I'm at 2 HP, and I really don't want to die, because I really don't know where I will restart if I do happen to, you know, if I do happen to bite the dust. Shit! And I can truly say that as of that play, this playthrough, that had never happened before. I had never gotten hit by those spikes on the right side. I guess I just went too far. These things are instant death, so be sure to be careful around them. Just gotta be super careful. I'm being the super careful guy. Alright. Gotta use these rocks. That if we touch them with anything other than our pogo jump, instant death. But we gotta use that pogo jump on these things to our advantage in order to get up to places that we couldn't normally reach to continue on with the level. Again, very simple old school platforming. And there is a 1-up, I am appreciating that. I do like the extra lives. I also like minecarts. Like minecarts because they give me health.
Get a move on, McDuck!
Right, more going across lava here. These enemies. And secret down here. All of the secrets. And more health. Jump out here. Yeah, I know what I'm doing. And this will take me over a million for the level. Which is pretty awesome. Alright, now we got these falling blocks here. Shit. Okay. I'll use the invincibility frames to get past that ghost really easily, so... not complaining about that at all, really. And look at that, there's even treasure up here. And this is actually the last section of the level before the boss. So we go down here. We get a couple more of these diamonds. And we'll go into this screen and it will be final boss time!
It took you long enough to catch up. What's the matter? Gold bricks in your caboose?
Oh, shut your beak. You're not getting any younger yourself, you old windbag.
Hush. Magicka may not know we're here yet. We don't want to lose the element of surprise.
So, you have decided to deliver Dime after all.
Release my nephews, you evil enchantress.
Oh, not until you show me number one Dime.
Here it is. Now let the boys... what?
It's been great doing business with you, Scroogey.
You too. You've been in cahoots from the beginning.
No, even before beginning. Do you remember who sold your painting in first place? 'Twas me in disguise, you fool.
Why, you... no wonder it was such a bargain.
$5 painting for you saved expensive treasure hunting expedition for me. And now, at long last, I am ready to use treasures to complete spell.
Enough with the smoke and mirrors routine. You've got my dime. Now release the lads.
Oh, boo-hoo. No time for buyer's remorse from old has-been. Better to stick with master plan. Is much more exciting. I now summon Dracula Duck. Behold! Dracula Duck, I, Magicka the Spell, have summoned you to do my bidding. You must obey my will and mine alone. And my will is that you destroy this meddling old fool.
Okay, so it's final boss time against Count Dracula Duck, who at first looks just like the NES version. You have to poke a jump on the bats in order to jump onto him.
Be careful.
But after you get a hit in, that's when things change. Magicka will throw a potion or something in there and make Dracula Duck transform into one of three things. The red one will turn Dracula Duck into a bunch of bats, in which you have to avoid by finding the one column of bats that has a space for you to stand in. And then after each of those transformation things, he goes back to being able to damage him. So, the green one is Dracula Duck turns into a dragon thing that has a really predictable fire pattern to avoid. Pretty simple, really. Alright, that's, what, three hits? This guy takes 7 hits to defeat, I believe. Alright, and the yellow one makes Dracula Duck giant, and he makes 5 attempts to try and bite you. This, out of the three, all three of them are pretty easy to dodge, but this one is probably by far the easiest to dodge. Alright, so something is going to happen with that part of the boss fight after Count Dracula Duck here has been hit 4 times, but we'll get to that in a moment. First, I have to try and dodge bats and fail at it. Alright, so I'm down to 1 HP, so... in order to not waste any more time and have to do the boss fight all over again, I have to freaking clutch this out. This is actually probably the hardest form to dodge. simply because you have to have good reaction time in order to get to the spacing time. Okay, here we go. After four hits, Count Dracula Duck will go higher up, but will also summon two bats in order for you to get to him. You know, if he didn't summon those bats, he'd be invincible, because I wouldn't be able to reach up there with my normal pogo jump. Whatever. Boss stupidity, ladies and gentlemen. It's video game logic at its finest. And I'm like, oh shit. So I didn't want to die there. I didn't want to die to a stupid bat. Trust me, I have done that enough times. Okay, that's six hits, I think, so one more. We have to withstand one more round of this. And like I said, this is probably the easiest form to dodge, because all you have to do is either get out of the way of it, or if you're in between the teeth things, just duck. Make Scrooge McDuck duck. And that's it! There's your final boss down.
Oh, boys, I'm so glad you're all right.
We knew you'd save us, Uncle Scrooge.
We knew you would.
We sure did.
Down that hall, lads. Launch pad will be waiting to take you to safety.
What about you, Uncle Scrooge?
Yeah, the whole place is falling apart.
Magic and Glumgold still have my number one dime, and I'm not leaving without it. You boys get going.
Good luck, Uncle Scrooge.
Now, give me dime.
Not till you give me those treasures. I want to be filthy, stinking rich.
You already are filthy, stinking rich.
But not as rich as that Chiseler McDuck. Where's the treasure?
No more horseplay. I need that dime.
Oh, no, you don't, Missy.
Let go, you fool.
Not till I get that treasure.
All right, so now it's a race to the number one dime. This is exactly how the NES version ended. You had to race Magicka and Glomgold to the top and get the number one dime. And there it is, right there. And we got it.
Nice try, Magicka, but I'll be taking my dime with me back to Duckburg. Have a lovely time together.
And that's where the original game ended, but here, there is now a section where we have to climb up and escape from rising lava. Which, honestly, this is still pretty simple platforming. And, you know, me doing this for the sixth time, I recognize the pathway in which to go and how to do it. And there we go, that's DuckTales Remastered.
My number one dime returns safe and sound.
But Uncle Scrooge, well, what about the treasure?
Yeah, we had it and we lost it. Sorry, Uncle Scrooge.
Come on now, boys. We may not have got to keep the treasure, but we had the adventure of a lifetime. And best of all, we got to share it together. You, Webigail, Launchpad.
And Duckworth, too. Don't forget about Mrs. Beakley and Bubba. And Fenton and Gyro, they helped us too.
Indeed they did, lads. Now come on, let's head for home.
Let go of me, you doddering old deadweight.
Oh, pipe down, you mangy bird.
Alright, real quick, the ending does not change based on the amount of money acquired, in case you're curious. I will shut up for this cutscene and the credits, which the credits contain two songs, the DuckTales theme and a beautiful piano arrangement of the stage theme from The Moon, and we'll say final thoughts for the bonus video. See you then.
It was real swell of you to give Glomgold a lift home, Mr. McD.
Aye. I'll put it on your bill, Flinty. You can pay me back in, oh, say 3 to 5 years. With interest, of course.
I'll get you for this, McDuck. Mark my words.
Now, there's a sight I never get tired of. Come on, lads. Let's head to the ice cream shop.
Hey, can we each get our own cone this time, Uncle Scrooge?
Oh, why not? I'm in a generous mood today. In fact, each of you can even get a cone with ice cream in it.
Oh, and one last thing. Here, this would normally say thanks for playing, but because we beat the game on extreme difficulty, it says dream and friends. And that's literally the only thing that changes. So, there we go. We'll see you in the bonus video.